Right now on BBC Two, Paul Mason keeps the faith with Northern Soul, the music scene, then and now, in the Culture Show.
Northern Soul is the musical religion that refused to die. Based on a devotion to obscure American soul music, this underground dance scene exploded across Britain in the 1970s. At its peak, people travelled hundreds of miles to dance all night, defying mainstream fashions and the charts. For a time, places that had been music hall jokes hosted some of the coolest nightclubs in the world. Northern Soul was the birth of late-night dance culture in Britain, and I was there. It's the 40th anniversary of the first Wigan Casino all-nighter, and this music still haunts me. For its devotees, Northern Soul is a way of life, and even now, it is perhaps the biggest underground music scene in the UK. But why? We were young, white, working class, thin, for reasons we'll come to, but we loved obscure black music. This was pre-Thatcher, pre-punk. Welcome to the mid-1970s. This is how we looked. This is what was on TV. And this is what we were supposed to dance to. This is how we reacted.
I need some soul, self-satisfaction, oh baby, oh yeah.
So, picture the scene. Electricity blackouts have cut the working week to 3 days. There's industrial unrest. Football violence, terrorism, and bad fashion. Now, I'd like to be able to pretend that, as a future economics journalist, I was gripped by the crisis we were living through. But I was bored with it, bored with pop music, and now, right on my doorstep was something underground and dangerous. One Saturday night, I left home with a change of clothes, telling my mum I was staying with a friend. But that was a lie. In fact, age 15, I was going to probably the greatest nightclub in the world.
Dynamite and nitroglycerin is like a firecracker compared to you.
At its height, Wigan Casino was pulling in crowds of up to 2,000 people every Saturday night from 2 a.m. until 8 a.m. on a Sunday morning.
You'd get to Wigan around midnight and all the ordinary people had melted away and the streets were just full of hundreds of young kids ready to dance to Northern Soul.
Take it easy, please!
By 1:30 a.m, the queue was about 10 deep and you had to shove your way in and then edge along the wall till you got to the front. All the while, people were buying and selling records and drugs. And as for the door policy, one bouncer and you were in.
Stop pushing at the back!
On the dance floor, it felt like, well, freedom. It felt like finding a new family. And a small part of me is still always there. But what is Northern Soul? All we knew then was that we loved the music. It was like Motown, but rougher, the emotions more raw. This was music made by unknown black singers in tiny studios for local labels in America's industrial heartland. Most of the time, we had no idea what they looked like. Some tracks were only ever demos, and for many of the records, only a few hundred were ever pressed. And it was this obscurity that fascinated us. Soul music had exploded into the British charts during the 1960s. But the super cool mods who went to clubs like the Twisted Wheel in Manchester wanted harder edged sounds to distinguish themselves from the mainstream. Some DJs started going to America to dig through crates of old vinyl stacked up in warehouses to feed our appetite for soul.
Northern Soul was about wanting records that had been flops because they'd been overlooked. It was about finding the hit that nobody else had found. It's artists trying to be the Supremes, the Temptations and Marvin Gaye who didn't have the money to make sophisticated records. So the records are slightly out of tune and slightly rough around the edges.
You'll never find a bad Northern Soul record. You know, the quality control is out of this world. Unbelievable. You know, you listen to those records and you think, why wasn't this a smash? We thought that of the Twisted Wheel, but we didn't care because we didn't have anything to do with the pop world, you know. We thought pop music was for morons.
The term Northern Soul was coined by music journalist Dave Godin when he noticed that Northern football fans coming to his record shop in London kept asking for heavy dance beat records nobody had heard of.
I think the soul music you might hear on the radio would probably have been sugary sweet, a lot of them. I mean, a lot of the labels started to add strings in about 1964, 65, and that was to get into a larger audience, a wide audience. There was a more earthy feel to Northern Soul. I mean, I did once term Northern Soul as deep soul with a dance beat. I think it was just a joyous coming together of the writers, the musicians, the arrangement, to create a record like the Vel-Vets, Gotta Find Me Somebody, which is almost like a religious experience when you listen to that record. Just the intensity that's gone into it all.
Twisted Wheel was shut down in the early 70s, but the flame had been lit. A circuit of all-nighters sprang up. Places like the Golden Torch in Stoke and Blackpool Mecca would become legendary. Suddenly, the venues our dads and granddads had danced ballroom in were repopulated, but with black music. Bit by bit, youth clubs, which had been home to kids dancing like zombies on Top of the Pops, were infiltrated by soul boys practicing their backdrops and their spins. And Elaine Constantine's soon-to-be-released feature film, Northern Soul, captures perfectly what happened for a lot of us. So this is the torch.
This is the Twisted Wheel period.
Twisted Wheel.
You can really see the mod influence there. And then it changes when it gets to Wigan.
Yeah, the hair got longer, the sideburns got longer.
God, I remember that. Working class culture was very pub orientated. It was very pop orientated. Mm-hmm. What were Northern Soul people doing when they created that subculture, do you think?
It was an elitism, kind of aspirational thing. There was a kind of special thing about Northern Soul that took you, elevated you out of the day-to-day.
Let's see you on that floor. Frankie Valli, the night.
The idea that it didn't sound cheesy and commercial was a big appeal, because, you know, no one wants to be spoon-fed shite from the charts, do they? I was in a youth club, and the experience of the music with these lads who were like older lads from school who would never show any emotion, were suddenly in this kind of, you know, dramatic situation where they were a spectacle and they didn't give a shit. I said to my older cousin, what's this? What is it? What's going on? She went, oh, it's Northern Soul. We sort of took over when we kind of got going, and there was still people hanging around who were into status quo or whatever, who were really annoyed about it, but there's nothing they could do. For me, Northern Soul, more than anything, is about the people. It's about the characters that it kind of attracts, how extreme they are, how obsessive they are. You know that every single person is going through every beat of that record with you, and you know that when you do that, it's all going to happen at that moment. And it's that sort of feeling of like, it's almost like you're all running the same race together. Do you know what I mean? And then that break's coming up, you're like, here we go, we're all ready for this, right, bang! And you're up there, do you know what I mean? And you're spinning or whatever, and you can just, in your periphery, you can just see it all happening around you, and everyone else is locked into it as well.
You're making me remember a lot, actually.
It's quite exotic in a way, because we're listening to black people's voices from America. And that was weird, you know. We didn't even know any black people. There's hardly any black families in our town. So it was like something very special. It's Northern Soul, it's actually from America.
There's something weirdly romantic about unknown black kids from no-hope towns in America making these records that then communicate across time and space with white kids from equally no-hope towns in Britain. It's only a few years ago that I actually got to go to Detroit and Chicago. I covered the housing crisis there, and it was heartbreaking to see the birthplaces of soul reduced to slums. But I met people quite surprised to find a white guy obsessed with soul singers few people in Motor City could still remember. What's also striking is the way those records go on communicating. Many of the original people are still on the scene, having followed that old Wigan motto, keep the faith. This is certainly the case for Pete and Susan Davis from Nottingham. They're getting ready to go to the Stoke all-nighter, one of the biggest in the country.
I don't think it's changed. The boast that doesn't change, even when you're sort of 15, 16.
Oh, no.
It's even now. You know, when people say living for the weekend, it's true. The rest of the week's just a rest period in between.
And on the Saturday, it's the soul night and the nighter, and then the Sunday and all day, then probably another night.
There's one on the bank holiday Monday,
yeah,
we do that as well.
Do that as well, don't we? Yeah, I mean, a lot of those lasses, you know, We wanted to go out with lads who were dancers. Didn't want to know anybody else. They got, if there was a good dancer, they were there. That's all, yeah.
Me, you mean?
Exactly.
I think it was a bit of one-upmanship. You know, they started really quite wide trousers. They got wider and wider and wider as people tried to better each other. Multiple pockets, multiple buttons on the sleeves.
They are all the same shoe, but different colours. That's my baby, that is. That one there.
Over the years, we've seen our friends, including ourselves, go through divorces and things like
yeah.
that. I mean, they've not had partners that are not sharing that love. It can be very, very stretching for a relationship, and they can't understand that passion, that drive, that you need to go. It's something you need to do.
I was born in 1961. I'm one of the originals back in the day, still on the soul scene. And it doesn't matter where I go, I'm always feel welcome. You meet different people from all walks of life. You know, believe it or not, you get judges, solicitors, police, you know, all sorts of people.
Took over my life, basically. It is a way of life. It's like when a song comes on, you know it, I just go in my own world, I sing it, and that's me. No one will disturb me through that song.
A little time. It showed me that you care.
Really want me to go, anyway. I didn't really want.
I love dancing. If I haven't danced half the night, I haven't enjoyed it. If my wife said to me, it's either me or Northern Soul, Northern Soul would come on top every time. And you can print it.
I haven't been to an all-nighter for over 30 years, but I think somewhere I must have some kind of muscle memory of how to do the dancing. Fran Franklin first went to Wigan in 1975, the same year as me.
Remember, back then, guys weren't really up front on the dance floor. They were sort of more like standing along the edges, eyeing up all the girls, thinking, oh, I'd love to get a slow dance with her. But there was, it wasn't like that on the Northern Soul scene. It was pretty much a bloke's thing.
Where do we think the dance style came from? Do we know whether American dance styles had anything to do with it? Because
I don't think so, because I think at the time it was all about Soul Train, and that's all about hips and boogie and disco and stuff like that. So I think it came from Bruce Lee.
Really?
All them rugged boys that had been to see Bruce Lee at the cinema thought, oh, you can use these moves. Show off, be damn hot on that dance floor, and all the girls will come flocking to us for a change. I think that's the secret.
Didn't completely work for me, but I've got a memory of it being like this. One, two, three, and one, two, three. But mine goes in threes.
Yeah, two, three, but it's not. It's
one, two. Well, where's, what am I missing? What
go
should
on,
I be doing?
Go on, go on. One, two, three, turn. One, two, three, four. One. Three,
see, I'm missing
four.
One. I can't seem to...
Yeah, when you're doing your changeover, that's a one, two. When you change direction, that's your fourth step. So do you want to give me a spin?
Right, OK. You can't do it by thinking about it. It's this.
No, you just do it. That's it.
And you keep... With the right shoes, it's fine.
That was pretty good.
And then you finish it with doing that.
Yep.
But I'm not sure I can even get away with
down
touching
and doing
the
a
floor.
Drop, but there you go. There. But you've got to push your knees in a bit more and have your knees over your feet.
You've got to get your knees over your feet.
Yes.
Right. I don't think we'll be practicing that one today.
Oh, you've not got the right shoes on. We'll leave it at that.
Should we do a bit of Northern Soul dancing?
Shall we?
Let's have a go. What did Wigan mean to you in your life?
This is the bit that gets me. It meant everything. Like, I grew up in a place called Muir House in Edinburgh, and my mum was on her own. There was four of us. And I spent most of my time, I was the big sister. I had to cook and do all the chores and stuff. So the minute that the soul scene sort of started, my mum was like, OK, that's your outlet, off you go.
What did it feel like to be black in that immensely white working-class scene?
Well, for me, it was like, I fit in. I've got a family. Every single person that I ever met on the scene felt like they were my brother or my sister. We were all... We are the Northern Soul crew. We went through good times, we lost people together, but we came together at the end of it as one.
I haven't done that for 30-something years. You had to be fit to dance Northern Soul, but not just that.
Think I might?
Illegal drugs, speed, usually amphetamines stolen from pharmacists, were a big part of the subculture. Essentially, dancers were overdosing on slimming pills or antidepressants, and you had to be as expert in the names of drug companies as record labels.
How dependent was Northern Soul on amphetamines?
Very dependent.
It couldn't have happened without the drugs. Why?
Music was fast. You couldn't drink and maintain that kind of energy. It was a completely nocturnal lifestyle. For a lot of kids, it became all-encompassing. They couldn't keep the jobs down. They couldn't live a normal
life. It was an obsession.
Yeah.
When the rave scene happened at the end of the 80s, it was almost exactly the same as Northern Soul to me. It was essentially 4/4 beat music with thousands of kids going to all-nighters, swap speed for ecstasy, and you've essentially got the same scene.
By the late 70s, Northern Soul was beginning to splinter into different factions. Some people wanted to stick with the old 60s sounds, but I'd become more interested in how black music was evolving into disco, hip-hop and funk.
See that black boy over there running scared, this old man in the bottom.
In 1977, a Granada film about the casino was seen by up to 20 million people. It helped put what had been a small underground scene in front of the whole country. But the casino was forced to close its doors for the last time in 1981. For a civic centre extension that was never built. For many, this was the end of an era.
If Wigan shut down, I wouldn't know what to do. I feel like instant nostalgia. That would be it. You think, God, I'm going to be looking back for the rest of my life. I won't really be able to cope.
That was how a lot of us felt then. We couldn't imagine life without the weekly buzz of Wigan. But as Dave Withers, star of the original Wigan Casino film, proves, life does go on.
I got married, had two children, got divorced, spent a lot of time in America buying records and ended up moving there about 12 years ago, and occasionally visit England probably about once a year. So yeah, life carried on.
But the Northern Soul scene also carried on. It's the first law of sociology. All youth subcultures eventually come back. In a small hall in Wigan, people from the Spotify generation are wearing, well, very wide pants and dancing to vinyl. They call themselves Wigan Young Souls.
Our aim was to bring a younger audience in. We knew that if we did play this music that this younger audience have never heard before, that they would grow to love it. In the 70s, there was stuff like ABBA and Bee Gees being played, and now there's stuff like, I don't know, Rihanna and whatnot, and that, but it's not the same as soul music. It's not pure.
One, two, three, four! A dance I used to do. They call them mashed potatoes.
More and more young people are getting into it. We are passionate about the music and we're passionate about us dancing.
It's just life.
It's just life.
Like, if I was to go clubbing, it just wouldn't be for me. Like, the music's rubbish. People usually start fights and stuff. Like, soul nights, everyone's like a family.
And it's an expanding family. Dozens of events take place every week, with an all-nighter happening somewhere in the country almost every weekend. Northern soul today has become part of a global culture. There are nights held from Tokyo to Dubai. It's influenced musicians, designers and choreographers, and some of the scene's best known songs have been reimagined and remixed into global hits. But I'm still not sure what it'll feel like to go back after so long.
I've not been to one of these for 35 years, and my big fear in coming here was that it would be a bunch of old, sad northern blokes reliving their youth. But it isn't really. However, we can do something about that. What it feels like now is what it felt like then, except plus 35 years in a body that can't really do it. But that music just takes hold of your body, and it took hold of my body and finally made it remember how to do that step I couldn't do before. It's not just nostalgia, because what is the same is the music. And some of that music captures not just something about black America, it captures something about working class Britain, and it captures something about me. It is the music that still communicates with you over continents and over four decades.
I think once you're locked into that record, it provides that escapism that you want from music.
You're thinking the lyrics, you're thinking the beat. You can hear the pain and the love and the glory and the music.
You feel like you belong.
Northern soul, in the end, for me, is all about emotional truth and what life should be like.
Passing seasons all but fade away into misty clouds of autumn gray. As I sit here looking at the street, little figures quickly moving feet. I'm just a pebble on the beach, and I sit and wonder why. Little people are running around, never knowing why. Oh, no, life is just a precious minute, baby. Open up your eyes and see it, baby.
Angela Merkel is a figure of our